altar of sacrifice and all that is about is sacrifices. And Abraham knows that I'm not in there. And God is working out the sacrifices. And now, who do you think one of those sacrifices could have been that God was in there working it out? The ultimate sacrifice is the Messiah is in there. And wow. So this is why I try to say that the promises of God, the sacrifices, the ultimate sacrifice has been paid. The only thing that keeps you from tangible, any of us from tangible holding, experiencing that particular, whatever it is that's concerning you, is your what? Belief. You got your belief right. And are you doing the things to keep your belief on the high level? Mm-hmm. Hurry up. Okay, verse 18. And in the same day the Lord made what? Okay, and to thy seed have I given what? From the river of what?
Egypt.
And to the great river? Israel had not seen that much land mass until it's been so long. The last time they saw that much ownership of a land mass was in the day of Solomon. Ownership. These are landmarks. The river of Egypt until the great river Euphrates. That's the last time in the Bible. The Bible gives us that description. 1 Kings 4:21. Now since Solomon's day has Israel actually owned that much real estate. 1 Kings 4:21, 2 Chronicles 9:26. That's where Israel had actually the ability to own and dominate that much land mass. So Abraham and the Jews know today that we know where our real estate is. So from the river Egypt to the great river Euphrates. If we look at a modern day map, would that be maybe Iraq? Does the river Euphrates run through Iraq today? Some of it through Iran today? All of that. So, well, yeah, we know how far the promises of God stretch. That's what he said he's going to give to us. And right now today, we are modern day man that's fighting over that real estate as to who gets it, who does it belong to. Israel says, it's right here in the Word. It's been with us. God promised it to us. And they ain't backing off of it. But the people that was, let's say here, the Amorites that are in there now, we got. What makes you think people come over here and get them? Because they don't believe, they don't read this Bible, so therefore they don't understand how they lost it. You've been judged because of the way you live. The sin, iniquity, filled God up, and he's judging. Now, he shows some glimpses. When the children of Israel came out of Egypt, they came out with silver.
Great substance.
They finally experienced it.
Even the politicians are now saying it ain't never going to happen. I guess, you know, they're
just saying, I'm apprehension. How is God going to do that? How is he going to do that?
Pretty much what God was telling Abraham when he allowed him to have that nightmare is, I'm making you this promise, but it doesn't matter whether anybody else lines up, whether the folks close to you line up, whether anybody else cooperates. It doesn't matter. It don't matter whether it looks like it's going to be good. They're going to be in slavery. They can't be a good thing, but it can't stop the promise.
It will not stop the promise. So all of I think it was Paul that says all of his promises.
Amen.
Just believe. Don't figure out in between. Just believe.